Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to watch YG Production Episode 1, The Making of Baby Monsters Shish Documentary. So, sobrang late ko na dito, like mga ilang hours, like 6 hours, 7 hours, ganun. Pero upload ko to sa gabi na kasi i-edit ko pa and may work pa ako. So hindi ko na to patatagalan kasi 17 minutes siya. So let's start. Oh my gosh, I'm back with Baby Monster. Ang tagal kong hindi naka-react. And promise guys, next week, i-film ko ng isang video yung mga hindi ko napanood na in-upload nila sa YouTube channel nila. So stay tuned for that next week.
The system at YG is
building ng
very
YG,
free.
Like, super ganda. Ang laki.
At the same time, we're all focused on the same and the vision that the YG DNA and the music.
Blackpink. Dance practice na lang,
sick girls. We used to just hang out, work on music, like, communicate with each other and be able to come up with ideas with each other. And it's a very free-flowing atmosphere. It's a place where we all hang out. Producers and artists find their unique sound, continually trying to get better at our craft. I think that's something that the atmosphere provides here at YG. I've been a YG producer here since 2009. I came into the company to work on the first album for G-Dragon. And I've been here for 15 years ever since. And it's been a ride and it's been a blessing. At YG, I've worked with Big Bang, G-Dragon, 21, Winner, Blackpink, Treasure,
lahat ng groups sa YG.
And now Baby Monster. My name is Choice 37, and I am a YG producer.
Grabe yung goosebumps ko kasi sa intro. Team Choice.
Originally, my style of making music, I usually produce music by myself. Around 2017, I guess there was a necessity for there to be more teamwork and more of like a team effort.
Okay, 좋아요. 고생하셨습니다. 잠시만.
So my team, it consists of Little G, Sunny, LP. Little G, he was originally an A&R at YG, and we became friends while we were working here. Sunny is an amazing songwriter. He's also a producer as well, beat maker as well, but he tends to write a lot more here, and he also vocal directs.
들어가면서 좀 약해졌어. 다시 볼게요.
네.
뭐 O N 정도 따라가면 괜찮을 것 같아요.
네.
아, 그렇게 볼게요.
And we have LP, who's a beat maker, a producer, a trumpetist, a guitar player, and he's an all-around great musician. We try to make sure that the song is paramount. We try not to let our egos get involved. We try to make sure that what we write and what we make feels good. And I think that's very important to the YG DNA when we collaborate YG as a DNA. Team and push each other to not settle for less.
Attention!
At YG, I think the reason why a lot of the artists are so talented is because one, I believe that YG picks the most talented artists. I know a lot of people kind of talk about this, but it takes a long time for a YG artist to debut. But the reason being is that they're continually honing their craft.
Can sing, can dance.
Working with Baby Monster, I think we always knew we were going to work with them since their training days. And it's always exciting just to see the talent that they have. The God-given ability that they have to be able to express themselves through music, dance, and
조금 힘을 많이 쓰는 것 같거든. Yeah, like just said, that's much better.
And seeing that, like during their training days, literally there were so many moments where like, wow, they're like monsters. Like, how did they get so good?
Yes.
Stack song, stack하고 rap하고 되게 비슷해 되거든, 사운드가.
how good they sing or how good they dance or how much charisma they have at such a young age.
Wow.
근데 나는 근데 어쩌라고 뭐.
좋은데?
여기 좋은데 이거?
여기에서 뭐 재밌는 애드립 하나 넣을까요?
네, 거기 뭔가 있으면 좋을 것 같아. 네.
세계로 그러니까 이렇게 약간
세계로?
어? 아사 뭐 평소에 하는 뭔가 재밌는 거 있어요?
너의 약간 뭐 너가 생각하는 아사의 트레이드마크 뭐 something 래퍼가 있으면 좋은데.
트위스 프로듀서님께서는 이제 랩 위주로 디렉팅을 많이 주셨어요. 저의 약간 장점이나 그런 단점 같은 거를 잘 아시는 분인 것 같아요. 그래서 단점은 어떻게 하면 더 나아질지 디렉팅을 주시고 또 장점은 또 칭찬을 해주세요. 그래서 너무나 좋은 분이시고 또 같이 작업을 할 수 있게 돼서 너무 너무 영광입니다.
네.
다시 하고 싶어요.
네, 예만. 라스트 이발리션 때부터 이제 계속 같이 해왔던 분이셔가지고 되게 편하게 할 수 있었던 것 같아요. 이제 저 같은 경우에는 무대 위에 올라가서 노래를 부른다고 생각하면 녹음할 때 잘 나온다고 해주셔가지고 그 생각을 많이 하려고 노력했던 것 같습니다. 녹음하면서 제일 신경 썼던 부분은 아마 pre-chorus 부분일 것 같아요.
Okay, so what we're here to do is actually maybe try to pre one more time. You did a good job, like a little bit more strength in it. But like that's the tricky part though. Like so we've thought of the two different ways that we could approach it. We could just have your minus 12, so do an octave lower of what you did. That for sure. And then maybe find one in between your main right now and in the octave low. Okay. Maybe a harmony, like maybe a fifth or something like that. Mm-hmm. And you could listen to it and then listen to your take. If you want to redo the take, it might be a good idea to redo the full take as well. Just straight from the beginning to end.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you sound better though. I think last time your voice was a little bit more lighter. But I think right now it's good. It has a little bit of weight to it right now. And let's do this. Okay, here we go.
Chorus 부분에
와,
제가 약간 랩처럼 불려야 된다고 하셨어요. 그래서 그거 조금 신경 많이 썼던 것 같아요.
When we first started working on Sheesh, it was very organic.
Me
and Sunny started writing to the verse and the pre, and then we couldn't get a drop, so we worked with LP, and he came in with that drop for Sheesh. And so that drop came in with LP's drop, and that's something that opened everything up. And when we heard that, I think it was just in my head. I was just like, wow, Sheesh.
드랍 부분에 가장 신경을 많이 쓰고 있었고요. 그래서 어떻게 해야 강렬함을 조금이라도 느끼실 수 있을까 열심히 작업에 임을 했던 것 같습니다.
어떤 느낌? 약간 되게
네.
고급져야 돼요.
고급
어떤 네. 느낌이냐면
네.
그 악당인데 되게 방금 막 둘러가지고 막
저 같은 경우는 제 파트가 가장 맨 처음 도입부가 있는데요. 그 부분이 소니 작가님께서 엄청나게 멋진 차를 타고 멋진 아우라를 뿜는 그런 느낌으로 불러달라고 하셨는데 그거를 상상하면서 불렀던 게 가장 기억에 남는 것 같아요.
사이가 지금 나쁘진 않은데 살짝 그 가짜 감정 같아요. 사할 때는 아 이래 좀 그렇게 해도 괜찮아요. 네네네. 그게 약간 예. 되게 킬링 포인트거든요. 사이.
Yes, the killing point. 마음껏 웃어봐. 이젠 내차례니까 천천히 불태워.
신경 안 쓰는 파트가 사실 없지만 굳이 하나의 파트를 꼽자면 브릿지에서
라미가 부른 천천히 불태워니가 잠든 사이 그 멜로디와 가사에서 제가 의도한 감정을 라미가 100% 완벽하게 소화했어요.
Chiquita has amazing vocal tone. I think it's something that you want to keep hearing over and over again. And she also can rap as well. And I think we haven't shown that yet, but hopefully we will someday.
Rap for Chiquita. Okay. 하늘이 가르지
우주는 흔들지 마음은 아르지 나쁘지 않거든? 치키타가 조금 더 하면서 조금 더 스테디한 플로우 지금 조금 좀 다이나믹이 맞거든? 야
들어봐주세요
야야야
하늘이 가르지 우주는 흔들지 마음은 아르지 하늘이 가르지 우주는 흔들지 말로만 아르지 그
가랑
흔에다가 그
액센트
쳐야 될 것 같아 하늘이 가르지
하늘이
가르지 우주는 흔들지
랩 선생님 아니에요 진짜로 근데 이 부분들이 되게 중요한 포인트예요 아사가 얘기했던
We wanted to show their range here Baby Monster's range YG specifically said he wants to show the range of the talents that these girls have because Baby Monster is so talented and they have so much to show and it's very limiting within that 3-minute song he wanted to show the full range of their talents and I think that's what she should really represent is to be able to present people just the taste of how deep their range is
how monsters they are
So there's like a, I guess a fun fact for the second verse, I guess. We had a different version of it, and I think it would be fun to let you hear it and see how, you know, it first started out with. There's many multiple versions, but this version, I'm just gonna let you hear. We actually recorded the girls. Got them all going. Big trap TikTok hitting with the pop-pop. Ooh. So that was a version that Asa did, and that was the original second verse.
여기를 많이 쪼개가야 돼. 네. 노래 이전에 마지막 부분이잖아. 여기가 마침표를 안 찍고 되게 애매하게 어중간하게 가가지고 노래까지 안 살아지고.
어떻게 해야 좀 더 다채롭고 재미있을 수 있을까 좀 고민을 되게 많이 했는데요. 이거 방향은 이렇게 가면 더 좋을 것 같다라고 생각하셔가지고 2절 랩 파트도 저희한테 보내주셨는데 아 이게 좀 더 다채롭게 이렇게도 갈 수 있구나.
아직 랩 파트가 안 정해졌으니까 일단 세 명이 들어가서 다 풀로 부를 거야. 그래서 가장 잘 어울리는 목소리로 나중에 조합해서 거거든.
3조로 스시 랩을 한다고 들었을 때 크게 거점은 없었던 것 같아요. 랩할 때나 보컬 할 때 톤이 달라가지고 멋진 시너지로 보이는 것 같고 노래가 더 좋은 것 같아요.
Go. 아사는 발음이 좀 말이 안 돼요. 발음이 좋아서 그런지 랩을 할 때 하는 게 되게 큰 매력이라고 생각합니다.
Luca who's amazing as well. I think she really when she gets in the booth, she tries to show you her performance. You know, we could hear it in her voice.
That's wild.
The performance she's gonna do on stage. That's something that she's good at.
소절 빠른 랩. 멜로디 랩 투소
진짜 왔다 갔다 한다
이제 이번에 아연이랑 저는 같이 하게 되었는데 랩의 구성이 달라져서 개인적으로 너무 좋은 것 같습니다
hey.
Welcome back
와 또 봐요 오는다 팀이 아연 after the hiatus
지금 첫 녹음이고 긴장해서 생각한 만큼
여러분
좀 아쉬워
걸어럽이랑 스토킹드미들 같은 경우에는 6인 버전으로 먼저 나왔었잖아요 7명 버전으로 이렇게 들려드릴 수 있게 되어서 너무 기쁘고
아연이도 이제 합류함으로써 더 멋진 시너지를 보여드릴 수 있는 것 같습니다
그리고 아연이 같은 경우는 되게 팔색조 같은 친구다 보니까 랩이면 랩, 저음이면 저음, 고음이면 고음 그러니까 어느 파트에 갖다 놔도 전부 다 자기 파트처럼 소화를 잘 하는 것 같아요
Wow.
So, the second verse and the last hook, we had a lot of issues with it.
Wow.
저희가 막사비라고 하죠. 정말 10번인가 20번인가 작업을 정말 계속 많이 했었어요. 아무리 해도 이게 안 풀려가지고 진짜 다들 되게 힘들어하고 있었는데 형관님이 막사비 자기가 한번 만들어 볼 테니까 한번 이제 줘봐라 해가지고 저희가 이제 온 거를 딱 들었는데 어? 이거다.
YG wanted to just get hands-on with it, and so he did. He took it home, and he worked on the second verse, and also the last hook. Hey. And we were shocked.
원래는 실시가 굉장히 밝은 무드였는데
수정을 하면 할수록 더 좋은 퀄리티가 나오는 것 같아서
저희의 카리스마 있는 모습이나 무대에서 연출들이 조금 더 멋있게 살릴 수 있었던 것 같고 최종적으로 만들어진 지금의 이 떼창이 좀 마음에 들었던 것 같습니다.
With Sheesh, we wanted to really surprise everybody. The next songs that we're going to put out, I think we're excited because, you know, we're going to be able to show the true talents of Baby Monster more and more. And to be able to just put it into a 3-minute song is very 아쉬워. It's very, like, you know, it's very limiting. But then, you know, we're going to do our best to be able to show their talents and show their true colors and their identity. And we're excited to be a part of that.
You can do it.
Okay, I can do it.
You can do it.
To all the YG fans, sincerely want to thank you. Through all the ups and downs, we really appreciate the support. It's because of your support that we're able to make this music and be able to give you something to feel and to enjoy, and we take a lot of pride and we are very grateful for the support. So thank you, and hope to see you guys soon.
Peace.
Peace. Thank you for making music. So ayan, grabe tong documentary na to, like pang Netflix ganun. And grabe talaga yung moment nung first na dumating si Ayon dun sa recording studio. Grabe yung moment na yon, like OT7. And grabe, like may nakikita ako sa Facebook na parang article siya ganun, na parang sinasabi na nag-over performing daw yung Baby Monster, which is what? Parang ang weird lang kasi pag naman hindi sila nag-perform ng all out, sasabihin naman mga lazy mag-perform ganon. So anong gusto talaga ng mga bashers na yan? Like ano talaga? Like pag nag-perform sila ng sobrang perform na ang galing-galing, sasabihin overperforming. Pero kapag ka hindi naman ginawa yung best nila, sasabihin ang lazy sa stage. Like ano talaga? Hindi ko na talaga din maintindihan sa mga bashers na yan. Like parang pag YG naman, YG artist, ang daming masasabi, like ang daming haters. Pag kunwari sa Blackpink, parang ganun din. Tapos ngayon naman sa Baby Monster. So wala na lang talagang mapansin yung mga bashers na yan. So ibig sabihin may mga bashers, sobrang dami. Ibig sabihin, sobrang galing talaga ng Baby Monster. Like wala na silang mapuna, yun na lang. So ayan guys, as promised, siguro next week mag-upload ako ng mga Baby Monster na hindi ko na panood last time. Like parang ilang videos ata yun, 4 or 3, hindi ko na din alam. So stay tuned for that, and siguro Blackpink kung meron man. I think yung kay Jennie ata sa Met Gala, papanoodin ko din yan. So next week yon. So that's it for today's video guys, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, annyeong!